Pile foundations are classified mainly into 9 types based on their design or function. Number 1 is end bearing piles. End bearing piles works based on the concept of end bearing. Here, the pile foundation in which the load bearing capacity is developed is based on the bearing developed at the toe of the pile that is placed on a hard layer like a rock, a dense or a hard gravel system. It develops most of the friction and bearing to support load at the toe of the pile as shown in the figure. At the end of the pile, there will be an end bearing through which sufficient capacity to bear the superstructure is obtained by the pile. End bearing piles transfer the load from the superstructure through any form of soil like soft compressible soil strata to a final hard strata. Hence, end bearing piles act similar to a column structure. Number 2. Friction of floating piles. Friction or floating piles develop the load bearing capacity by shear stresses developed along the sides of the piles as shown in the figure. The pile hence transmit the load to the surrounding soil by friction between the surface of the pile and the soil. The load is transferred downward and laterally to the soil. Next is a combination of end bearing and friction piles. Piles can also be constructed by the principle of both end bearing action and friction action. So, piles carry load by the combination of friction and bearing action. For example, as shown in the figure, if a pile can pass through the soft soil that provides sufficient frictional resistance and finally finds a firm layer that develops load bearing capacity by end bearing, then such a pile system is a combination of end bearing and friction piles. Number 4 is anchor or tension or uplift piles. As the name says, these are piles used to resist extra tension or uplift of structures happening due to some external lateral force. So, these piles are used to anchor the superstructure from overturning or tilting. So, anchor piles are used to provide anchorage against the horizontal pull. Tension or uplift piles are piles used to anchor the structures that are subjected to uplift due to the issues like overturning pressure, overturning moment that are derived due to horizontal forces. Number 5. Compaction piles. Compaction piles are used to compact loose granular soils to increase the bearing capacity of the soil. Especially sand pile is used to form a compaction pile as it need not carry any load. This is a technique that is mainly used as a soil stabilization method. Number 6. Fender piles. Fender piles are piles constructed to protect waterfront structures against the impact from ships or any other floating objects. Fender piles can be used in combination with other piles. Number 7. Is sheet piles. Sheet piles are steel section piles with interlocking edges that are driven into the ground to provide permanent or temporary earth retention and excavation support during the process of construction. Number 8 is batter piles. Batter piles are piles that are driven into the soil at an angle with the vertical so that they achieve a load carrying capacity for the foundation. It is usually provided at an angle of 14 to 20 degree with the vertical. They are mainly used in combination with other group piles. The figure shows a combination of foundation pile, adjacent to which we have sheet piles, batter piles to support the floating structure. We also have anchor piles to protect the structure from overturning. Number 9. Laterally loaded piles. A laterally loaded pile are piles designed to carry lateral loads. When a laterally loaded pile is subjected to a lateral load, a part or whole part of the pile tries to shift horizontally in the direction of applied load, as shown in the figure, which is causing bending, rotation or translation of the pile. The pile presses against a soil mass that is lying in the direction of the applied load, generating compressive and shear stresses and strains in the soil. So this is what offers resistance to the pile movement. Laterally loaded piles are used mainly to support retaining walls, bridges, dams or act as fenders in docks as well as harbors. If you like this video, let us know by liking, sharing, and subscribing to Civil Engineering Fanatics.